So the spider is a very basic, easy fold, even though it looks a little intense on some shirts. This square piece of material will represent a shirt. We'll consider this top point the neck. So basically the shirt's running neck to bottom, sleeves will be here. All you're going to do is fold it sleeve to sleeve, so it's exactly in half. Okay. And then, depending where you want your spider, whether you want it to start in the middle, I would suggest you go up just a little bit. About 3/4 of the way up the shirt then, you're going to start your spin. You're going to grab it at the fold point and start your spin. And that's whether you like to spin it like this or walk all the way around the table. You'll get your spin. And that is the beginning of the spider. When we talk about the nice tight spin, this is what we're trying to accomplish. You can see where your fingers would be. And you're trying to wind it up as tight as possible into a very nice whirly spiral type of material pattern. Here's the spin now, all finished. We just need to tie it off with string or elastics if you wish and get it ready to die. So a good tight spin and tie, you should be able to pick it up. Flip it over. You can see the nice beautiful spiral here. This is what you really want to get. That's what you're shooting for. It takes a little bit of practice, but never give up. Spider, really. Some people call it a mirror, but really I'm trying to create a spider itself. You're going to take the center with your darkest color and you're going to make the base of the spider, which I'm doing with just a dot here. And then you're going to bring the point out along a fold. Okay, you can see the lines of the fold. If you can do it precisely, you get a pretty cool result. But it's okay if you can't do it precisely, because it's still pretty cool. Okay, now what I did is I just followed a circle fold, you know, one of those little folds around. And that's it. I try not to soak in it too much. And I'm going to bring it out another one, a little bit. And I might expand upon this one. Okay, this first one we're just going to do like that. I'm just going to show you the other side quick. You're going to try to repeat it on the other side as best you can, but it's not quite so easy. So I'm not going to be too concerned. I'm just going to come out a little bit here, just so that one does exist. It's probably a little difficult to see. All I did was a really tiny little one. Okay? This side's going to have the bigger one. Okay, now the next step. Now whatever colors you want to use, I'm just doing a 3-color dye. Two main colors and the spider is a dark navy blue. This is a fuchsia color. Okay? I'm just going to make it nice and simple. Okay? There's many, many different ways to apply your dye. And all of them are right. Okay, and then I'm just going to continue the rest with the turquoise. I'm going to allow the turquoise and the fuchsia to make a color band in where they meet. That should form a new kind of purplish color. That's it. Nice and simple. I'm going to flip this over and do the other side. I'm going to wipe this little table thing off first, though, before I add this color to the other side so that nothing transfers. And we'll see what she looks like when we're all done. Okay, so here is the other side. Now, on this side, we're not going to go quite as deep with the color, as in not adding as much liquid to the color, because the shirt is already soaked through from the other side. We don't want to go too crazy. The idea behind this screen, this mesh thing that you see here, is actually out of a fridge or a stove, is that when I put too much dye into the material or the shirt, it allows it to drip through instead of pooling, say if you were using newspaper or something else. The pooling can sometimes make a nice effect, but most times it ruins your shirt. Okay, I'll fill the rest of this in, make it nice and neat. I'm going to make it a solid dye. You don't have to. You can leave white. It all adds to different things. And then we'll finish this shirt off and open her up.
Hello, darling. This is Louis. Darling, it's so nice to have you back where you belong. You looking swell, darling. I can tell, darling. You still growing strong. I feel the room swaying from the band's playing one of our old favorite songs from way back when. So take a rap, fellas, find an empty lap, fellas, darling, never go away again.
Preliminary rinse. A little bit of dye runoff is normal. Nothing to be worried about. We'll rinse this all out and we'll take a look.